Personally, I have grown tremendously through the past 6 weeks. And more importantly, I can see how this experience will help me grow further long after the fellowship is over. I would like to look at this in sort of the three E's that I normally evaluate my growth on. The first E being education, the second E being exposure, and the third E being experience. So as a leader, the education component of the fellowship has been terrific. I have tons of books that I've already purchased that will be an important toolkit into the future. That education has helped me to be more confident as a leader, to lead more authoritatively, to listen more to people, and to understand that leadership is about influence. It's about the why that people see in me that gives them the reason to follow. And in terms of exposure, that I would speak in terms of my exposure to the American system here and the exposure to the 24 other great African leaders that I have been with here for these 6 weeks. That has been amazing in terms of understanding how they think and sometimes how we see things so differently when we are looking at the very same thing. I think that level of appreciation of diversity and the ability to tolerate diversity is something that I've grown in over the last 6 weeks, and I can see how I will grow long after this fellowship is over. Experience-wise, we had time to visit other great leaders in the community, particularly the celebrated leadership of the mayor of this city. I can see the very qualities of a great leader in him that combines the power of his exposure, the power of his education, and the power of his Herculean will to have his people and his city succeed. So that stands out and improves. I can see how it has improved me as a leader and how it will impact my leadership long after this fellowship is over. It's been great meeting tons of people and collecting tons of business cards, and not only that, but establishing a relationship. And I think those relationships are critical to the next step in my career, the next step in my business, and the next step in my mission to support other people to get ahead financially. The third thing has to be the exposure that I got here. We visited a few cities in the United States. We visited a few companies as well. What stood out for me was the fight that every regular American is putting together to realize the American dream. And I think that is super important in our markets where, yes, we do fight, but there is the feeling sometimes to hold back in the hope that someone else is gonna show up to do what we're supposed to do ourselves. So I think that exposure is tremendous and will definitely change the way we look at and conceive how we should proceed in terms of continuing to realize our African dream. My message to fellow Africans is, you know, if you observe the sheer power of the United States as a country and its people, I think the United States as a market commands that attention from the world space because they're united. These are 50 different states, 50 different geographies. And what we've observed is that they're doing so many different things, but together as America, they form a tremendous force in the world economy. My advice to my fellow African leaders is that perhaps the time is gone when we want to make a name for ourselves as individual countries in Africa. My hope is that this fellowship brings us closer together. We can be as politically different as we can be, but there needs to be some consensus behind the idea that as long as we continue to speak as separate small African economies, we're probably not going to command much in the world markets. I urge my African leaders to say, let's come together as African leaders. Let's come together and collaborate in championing entrepreneurship. Let's come together in, you know, speaking and dictating terms to the world market about what we have to offer as Africans, as one continent. And we owe it to this generation and future generations to create a continent and an environment that our children and the future generations will be proud of.